Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Jeanie Buss, once again, raising eyebrows with comments made publicly, this time in an interview with Sam Amick regarding Russell Westbrook, his future with the Lakers, his relationship with Patrick Beverley. She even calls Russell Westbrook the best Laker from last season. Yeah, that's generated quite a few headlines. I'm going to get into it. Should we really be worried about what Jeanie is saying here? But quick reminder, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, ring that notification bell as well, and of course go ahead and click the like button on this video. All right, so Jeanie Buss in this interview with Sam Amick of The Athletic mentions that Russell Westbrook and Patrick Beverley, the dynamic between them, she's asked about this situation. Is this a precursor, bringing in Patrick Beverley, is this a precursor to a Russell Westbrook trade? And she says, no, look, a lot of people are focusing on the history between Patrick Beverley and Russell Westbrook. And look, let's be honest here. That's fair that we focus on that because they've got, well, again, quite the history. They have had a very contentious past relationship. As early as last season, look, when the Minnesota Timberwolves played the Lakers, Patrick Beverley was very demonstrative in his thoughts on Russell Westbrook. So it's fair to wonder whether or not the two can coexist this season. Jeanie Buss says, no, we've seen this dynamic play out before. We saw it with Kobe Bryant and Matt Barnes. Matt Barnes was known to be a Kobe agitator, and they played on the same team together down the road. That happened, and it worked out just fine. And she's not wrong. We've seen that dynamic play out quite a bit. Look, Lance Stephenson became a Laker and played alongside LeBron in his first year with the Lakers. So a known LeBron agitator got along just fine from what we've heard with LeBron James. So this is not a new narrative or dynamic that we've seen in the NBA where former foes come together on the same team and things work out. It actually happens fairly often in the NBA. So Jeanie Buss said, look, they're not worried about that. Also adds in, though, that getting Patrick Beverley had nothing to do with Russell Westbrook. It was not an indicator that Westbrook was on his way out. She said that they just wanted Patrick Beverley for Patrick Beverley, for who he is, for his work ethic, for how he approaches the job. She said the day of the trade, he was already here after work hours, working out. So the day Patrick Beverley was traded to the Lakers, he showed up at the facility and was working out. That's great to hear, by the way. Just as an aside, that's fantastic. Patrick Beverley already locked in, already in the facility, already working out. Wonderful stuff there. But she said, look, this is about getting Patrick Beverley. This is about how he plays defense, him being the guy that knows how to push his teammates, how to set an example. That's what they wanted, not someone necessarily to replace Russell Westbrook. Now, a lot of fans, though, will look at that and say, oh my gosh, this means they're keeping Russ. I wouldn't go that far. See, here's the thing. Even if, let's say the Lakers, in their mind, they were saying, let's get Patrick Beverley because he's going to replace Russell Westbrook. We're going to trade Russ. You can't say that. You can't say that publicly right now. All that does is damage your leverage in any kind of trade negotiation. So even if that was what the Lakers were thinking, Jeanie has to say what she said here. Now, I'm not saying she's lying here. This could be exactly 100% true and exactly how the Lakers view things, that Russ and Patrick Beverley are going to get together great, and then Patrick Beverley is not replacing Russell Westbrook or is not an indicator of what the future is for Russ with the Lakers franchise at all. Maybe that's the case, but regardless of whether or not it is, this is the message that has to be put out there publicly. Now, from there, this is the part that really has people upset. She says, all I can say is that from my point of view, Westbrook was our best player last year. Best player. Yeah, a lot of people latching onto that word best, and for good reason. Because Russell Westbrook was not the Lakers' best player, all you have to do is look at the advanced metrics. Heck, watch the games, and you could see that Russell Westbrook was not the Lakers' best player last season. Now, I've said many times, I think he's better than what we saw last season. I also think a lot of people are probably using him to be a scapegoat a bit too much. There were a lot of factors involved in the Lakers' struggles last season, to put it mildly, but Russell Westbrook was certainly a big part of that. He definitely was not the best player. Now, Sam Amick thought the same thing, followed up with Jeanie Buss, messaged her after the interview and said, did you really mean to say best? And she said, no, she didn't mean to say best. What she was trying to get across was that he was the most consistent Laker, which if you look at the next sentence, that fits much better. If she was thinking in her head consistent and just said the word best, following that up with, he played pretty much every single game, showed up, worked hard. That fits if the word consistent was in there instead of the word best. So while a lot of people are going to latch on to that word best Laker, I don't believe that's what Jeanie intended to say. But this is also not the first time this summer that what Jeanie has intended to put out publicly has not been either put out the right way or has not been the message that was received publicly. We think about the tweet from earlier in the summer. That's not great. That's not ideal when the person who is running your team is putting out messages that aren't exactly what they mean to say, or not aren't conveying the exact message that is being intended, right? That's not an ideal situation. But I do buy that Jeanie Buss just misspoke here, that the word best should really just be substituted with most consistent, because I don't think you can really argue with that. On a team that had 41 different starting lineups, Russell Westbrook was indeed there for 78 games. So the word consistent definitely fits. Best, that does not. She does add in, though, I would love to have seen what this team would have looked like if they stayed healthy. It's really tough to win when AD is not on the court. LeBron was hurt a lot of the season. Russ was there every night. I really appreciate him for who he is and what he brings to the team. That has a lot of people concerned, too. It's all very positive. It's all deflecting blame away from Russ. It's saying that the Lakers' struggles were in part due to Anthony Davis being hurt, part due to LeBron being hurt, which, again, isn't wrong. You're deflecting some of the blame away from Russell Westbrook with this comment and then praising Russ about who he is, him playing hard every night, showing up every game, all of that. That's got fans concerned. Oh, no, if this is really how Jeanie thinks, does that mean that they're not going to trade Russ? This, though, let me tell you, should come as no surprise. This statement is not a surprise at all if you've listened to anything the Lakers have said all summer long. Every opportunity the Lakers have had to praise Russell Westbrook, they have taken it and ran with it. Rob Pelinka, when talking about Russ picking up his player option, mentioned that they would welcome him back with open arms. Darvin Ham has been just gushing over having Russell Westbrook on the roster, over all these ideas he's got for how to make him fit. That doesn't change the fact that the Lakers are trying to trade him. They've been trying to trade him all summer. We've been hearing all these different reports, right? The big holdup right now. Will they actually give up both first-round picks in a deal to send Russell Westbrook elsewhere, whether it be Indiana or Utah or wherever? But publicly, the Lakers have consistently praised Russell Westbrook. Why? Again, because this is what you have to say. Jeanie Buss can't come out there. And again, maybe she does feel this way about Russell Westbrook. Really, maybe she does really wish that she got to see LeBron, AD, and Russ for more than 21 games fully healthy. I think that's fair. I think that's something that most people would say probably helps to some degree. Now, I would say it's not enough to make Russell Westbrook work with the Lakers. I think he simply isn't a fit. Until I'm proven otherwise, I'm going to be skeptical that Russ will work with this Lakers team. But Jeanie Buss has to say this publicly, has to say this and put this out there, because, again, it only hurts you in leverage situations, in trade discussions, if Jeanie says, you know what, we don't think Russ really fit and we're going to try to make a move. That doesn't help you out on the trade front at all. Instead, this has to be what you put out there publicly, because remember, not only are you in trade negotiations, but there's a chance that Russell Westbrook gets brought into training camp. What if he can't find a deal? If you've said negative things about him all summer and then you bring him into training camp, well, that is an even more difficult situation to deal with. So you're making a bad situation even worse if you don't say this kind of stuff right now. This has to be the message that's put out there. Again, doesn't mean Jeanie is lying, but I think this is a good bit of PR work from Jeanie Buss in terms of putting out the message that frankly has to be put out there right now. And maybe it isn't the one that Lakers fans want to hear, but still, it's what they have to say as of this moment. The word best, yes, that was definitely a mistake. But overall, I think Jeanie did a good job putting out the message that needs to be and the message that the Lakers have consistently put out there all summer long, even if it might rattle Lakers fans a little bit to hear all of this positive talk about Russell Westbrook, who's a player that a lot of fans would like to see traded elsewhere. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you think about the way Jeanie handled this situation? How big of a deal is it, do you think, that she misspoke and said the word best, called Russell Westbrook the best Laker from last year? Again, give me your thoughts in the comments section. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe. And see ya.